right wing, and right on the issues. Steve Gill.
The economy is what I do. It's what I know. It's what I've done. I haven't just read about it. I haven't just debated about it. I haven't just talked about it in subcommittees. I've actually done it. Started businesses, run businesses. I know how to do it. And I want to get it to work again.
Wow, a candidate whose knowledge of economics and the economy is not just based on the Cliff Notes version. That's Mitt Romney's pitch, the Republican presidential candidate, former governor of Massachusetts, and fresh off a visit to my one of my old schools. You know, my dad was in the Air Force, so I went to 10 different schools across the country. Like Mitt Romney, I've got about 12 home states. But went to West Hills Elementary in sixth grade, where Mitt Romney was last night holding an event in Knoxville as he battles on Super Tuesday or for Super Tuesday votes. And Governor Romney, good to have you with us.
Well, thank you, Steve. I didn't know I was in your alma mater.
My house actually was across the street. I could literally walk across the street to school the year that we lived there. Heard you had a big crowd there, a big enthusiastic crowd.
It was absolutely extraordinary. We had a huge group of people, very cheered, very excited. People recognized that we're on the cusp of getting a nominee that can defeat Barack Obama.
You've seen a big surge. We're looking at poll numbers in Ohio, in national numbers, Tennessee, where you've closed within the margin of error here, in the margin of error in Ohio. You've literally seen about a 10-15 point shift in Santorum's numbers and yours, again, both nationally and in these key states in just the last 10 days. Obviously, his debate performance in Arizona, your wins in Michigan and Arizona, and now Washington State over the weekend have fueled a lot of that. You have to like the trend lines. Are you going to be able to win in Ohio and Tennessee?
Well, I sure hope so. You're right. The momentum has come our way. Five states in a row now have voted for my campaign. I think the reason we're doing so well is that I have focused my effort on the issue people care about most, which is our economy and getting government out of the way, getting it smaller and ending these deficits. You know, jobs and a bright future for our kids is what it's all about. And the other folks in the campaign have been talking about almost everything but the economy. I mean, they're known for a lot of other things, but the economy is not one of them. And I think people want a president who's focused on getting that job done.
One of the things that we saw over the weekend, you may not have seen it, but Newt Gingrich was on NBC with David Gregory, and he started trying to get into the whole, what do you think about Rush Limbaugh? And Newt literally slapped him back by saying, look, people are concerned about the unemployment rate. They're concerned about Iran getting a nuclear weapon. They're concerned about gas prices. And then the media constantly wants to get into this silly stuff. I think people are concerned and ask constantly whether you will be as aggressive with the media. One of the things they like about Newt is he's attacked the media when they get into these different distractions. People want to know that you're going to be just as aggressive in pushing back, not just at the media, but at Barack Obama in the fall.
Well, no question. If you watch my speeches, and you had a good clip from one, I go after the president pretty aggressively. This president has failed us. There's no question about that. He came into office. The key job he had to do was to get our economy growing again, and he failed to do it. He took his time and focused on Obamacare and Dodd-Frank and card check and cap and trade and trying to cut off our use of energy in this country, our carbon-based energy sources, investing in solar and wind. Look, he had his own agenda, and his agenda failed the American people. And this, we're going to beat him by focusing on his failures, not focusing on a whole series of extraneous issues that come up from day to day that I see a lot of people get consumed about. But look, guys, back to the economy, back to his failure to end the massive deficits we have. If we go back to the things that really matter, we'll win this election.
Some of your critics are concerned that Obamacare will be off the table because of your health care plans in Massachusetts to some resembling what got adopted by Barack Obama nationally, difference in a state and a federal plan. And Red State today is out pounding you, saying you actually encouraged a national mandate. I got to tell you, I went back and read your op-ed in USA Today. I'm not seeing it. I mean, I'm looking at what you wrote. I didn't see anything in there that indicated you were telling Obama we need a national federal mandate like what you did in Massachusetts.
No, time and time again, throughout the Massachusetts experience, I pointed out this is a state plan. It is not a national plan. It should not be adopted by the nation. I said that from the very beginning. And, of course, we had, I think, 13 debates last time I was asked, when I'm talking about 2008, I was asked time and again about our plan. I said, no, this is a state plan. It's not a federal plan. But We're not going to take Obamacare off the table, let me tell you. And I can point out that what we did that did not raise taxes $500 billion or cut Medicare $500 billion. And it also did not affect health care for the 92% of our people that already had health care. And that's very different than Obamacare. I'm delighted to debate Obamacare with President Obama because my plan works, his plan doesn't. And the idea of a federal takeover with Obamacare is a completely wrong direction for the country. That's why I will repeal it, and I will also stop it on day one.
We're starting to see, and I know it pleases you, a more of coalescing of Republican leaders behind your campaign. And again, if you can win some of these major states, Ohio and Tennessee and some others on Super Tuesday, Santorum looks to be running out of money. If you can continue to coalesce with endorsements by Eric Cantor, by Tom Coburn, by Donald Trump, who's going to be joining us, by the way, in about 10 minutes, how do you then get past the bitterness of the primary? I mean, you've been involved in politics for a long time. Primaries are difficult. How do you then heal things and mobilize and energize that conservative base that has really been out there saying anybody but Romney for a while?
You know, I've gotten to know Newt Gingrich and Rick Santorum pretty well. We chatted together just a couple of days ago when we were doing a Huckabee forum. You know, we get along pretty well on a personal basis. We're going to come together assuredly when this process is over, and we're going to support our nominee. And I think people in our party recognize we have got to get rid of Barack Obama. He is just crushing our economy, and he's jeopardizing the future for our kids. And perhaps he's the best community organizer of conservatives we could have imagined, because he will bring us together. Are we pulling in different directions right now among different candidates? Of course, that's the nature of a primary. But we will come together. I predict that our party will come together in a way we have not seen in a long, long time, because we recognize we have to. It's important.
So Obama's kind of the quasi-chairman of conservatives for Romney.
he's the chairman of – he is the organizer of conservatives across this country to get behind whoever our nominee will be.
Both Newt Gingrich and Rick Santorum are saying they're going to continue on with this long slog. If you are successful in winning in Ohio, perhaps winning in Tennessee, do you think it's effectively over after Super Tuesday, even if you don't have the delegates, the 1,144 magic number? It's going to take a while to get there. Do you think it's effectively over if you win those key states tomorrow?
You know, I can't predict what's going to happen tomorrow, of course, and I don't want to speculate as to what might happen under different circumstances. I do believe that I will be able to get the 1,144 delegates I need prior to the convention.
So a brokered convention isn't something that you think is on the horizon?
You know, that, I just don't think that's going to happen. I can tell you that the three of us, or the four of us, including Ron Paul, we're not about to all go to the convention and have the nominee be someone other than us, someone who hasn't been vetted, someone who hasn't been working on the trail for the last 2 years, raising money and building an organization. That's not going to happen. It's going to be one of us, and whether it takes a long time or can be done more quickly, that's up to the voters, but we're going to get the job done.
No Disney World quick pass to the front of the line for somebody else.
That's exactly right.
I know Florida's already passed, but we can still talk about them. Governor Mitt Romney, good to have you with us, and thank you for joining us. And we'll talk with you again, I'm sure, in the next couple of months.
Great. Thanks so much. Good to be with you this morning.